This illustration, for instance. You discover that times are given in optimistic, most likely, and pessimistic form. And there's a need for you to determine the mean time. There's a need to determine the mean time, because the mean is going to be the average that you will use in determining the critical part. The mean is the average you will use in determining the critical part. So, in determining the mean, it is optimistic plus four, most likely, plus pessimistic. Divided by, of course, during examination, I like telling people this secret. The only thing you need to know is the one that is at the top. 0 plus 4, m plus p. What you want to use in dividing it, don't bother your head. This is like 1, this is 1, this is 4. 4 plus 2, 6. So 4 is the only thing you should be concerned about is what are you using to multiply the most likely? 4, that's all. And the moment you know that this is 1, this is 1, because for that 6, so that's why you divide by 6. So get the mean. For instance, the first mean is going to be 1 plus 4 times 2 plus pessimistic is what? 3, all divided by 6. 4 times 2, 8, 9, 12. 12 divided by 2. This will give us 12 divided by 2, which is got what? 6. 12 divided by 6 will give us 2. And that is the mean. That is the mean for this. To get the next one, is 2 plus 3.5 times 2 plus 8. All divided by 6. 2 plus 3. 3.5 times 2, that's 7. 7 plus 2, that's 9. Plus 8, that's 17. That's 17. This becomes 17 over 6. And 17 divided by 6
times 4. 3.5 times 4.
It is 4 times 3.5. 4 times 3.5. So 3.5 times 4. That's 14. Plus 10, that's 24. So it gives us 24 over 6. 24 divided by 6 will be 4. The next term will be 6 plus 4 times 9 plus 18 divided by 6. 4 times 9, 27 or 36. 36 plus 6, that's 42. 42 plus 18, now 60. 60 over 6, that gives us 10. This way, we are going to arrive at the mean value for all this. That's the only difference between the project evaluation review techniques method and the critical path method. That means, instead of picking 1, 2, or 3, as what we are going to use in determining the critical part. These are the values we will use. So the only thing you need to know for now is how to combat the optimistic, the most likely, and the pessimistic values to a mean value. Of course, if you want to go a step further by determining how long it will take you to complete a project or the parameter of complete a project within a particular time, then you need to be talking about variance. And variance is P, pessimistic minus optimistic, all over 6, and raised to all raised to power of 2. Of course, like I said, this is just an introductory part to project evaluation of the technique. So when we get to the second level of evaluation management, we'll be handling it. Thank you.